Hi, I'm Michael Fischer. I'm the art director here at Yakkety Yak, and I'm going to show you how to build a social media template using Canva. Canva is for beginner to intermediate level of designers. It can be useful, especially for creators who want to enable some degree of standardization across their materials and do not need too much freeform control over each unique piece. My first step in terms of recommendations is acknowledging these two areas of the site. Here you have a scroll through on various social media and general print templates that you could approach in terms of dimension. Here in the dropdown, you also have the option of selecting pre-formatted templates, or you have the option of clicking here to create a custom dimension. For the sake of this example, I'm just going to create a custom dimension to what is the newer dimension for Instagram, which is the taller dimension, which is 1080 by 1350 pixels. So I'm creating this new design. And here within this new design, you can see that I have a blank canvas. And if I wanted to, I could grab one of these pre-formatted templates. I could drop it here. And I can immediately jump in and start saying whatever language I would like. In this event, we're pre-formatting something that could be an invitation of some sort and just dropping in the content. If I wanted to make a million versions of this, I could just copy it over and over. And I can easily delete all of my iterations. To continue on this example, I just want to start to show how you can customize these things a little bit yourself. So the first thing here are your colors. So if I had a particular brand color that was specific to my company and the company that I was working for, I'd be able to come in here and insert that color based on using the hexadecimal system. Hit enter, and you've then created a swatch for this piece. To begin adding type, you have pre-formatted type setups in terms of pre-suggested type hierarchy, in terms of things that look good from a contrast standpoint. So you have sort of these, not necessarily basic, but simple approaches to coming in and formatting your content. With these, you can also do customization for color. And again, it's a very simple type text frame that you can come into and you can immediately customize it and make it to yourself. For this example, I want to show a little bit more of the flexibility that Canva has for personalization. And to begin this, I'm going to actually start by uploading my brand logo. So here at Yakkety Yak, we have two logos that we use mainly, one that is set up with white type and one that's set up with dark blue type, so that we have some variation in terms of what we're able to use our branding for. Here you can bring in a million different backdrops for backgrounds and textures that you can use in your design. If you want to use gradients, if you want to use flat colors, if you want to do photographs, Canva offers all of this to you so that you don't have to go in and get a custom stock photo application site. In this event, I just want to use a really simple gradient and incorporate that logo that I just brought in to my design. And so you can see here that Canva offers grids and guides to help you align all of your items so that really anybody at any level can come in here and make something that is a little bit worthwhile. As I continue to build this out, if I wanted to incorporate some kind of a shape to help highlight whatever the text is that I'm adding into my design, I can bring that in here, and then I can go back into this area where all the type is, but instead of pulling in something that's already pre-formatted for me, I can go in and I can just select a type box, and I'm able to look at through all of the library that is Canva's type options. There's really an infinite number of options that you can use here. You also have the opportunity to upload fonts. If you're using something like Adobe or Google Fonts or any type of open typeface, you're able to upload that into Canva and use that. For this example, I want to use Century Gothic. And I'm just going to call this steps to using Canva. You can see here, it's still just very simple black type within this white box. But even though this is much, much smaller than this logo, already with the way that I've begun to construct the design, this really pops out and grabs a lot of attention. And then as I continue to just push and incorporate more design elements within the options that Canva provides, this slowly starts to come more and more to life. Similar to what you would see within Photoshop or Illustrator, you have options to control your letter spacing, which is either known as kerning or tracking, as well as your line height, which is also known as leading. If I wanted to change this color, it's as simple as a highlight, and then coming in and selecting some of the colors that I've already uploaded into Canva as an option for templates. If I wanted to adjust the transparency of this so that I could see just a little bit more of that gradient, I could. For this example, it doesn't really make sense because it just sort of blends away. But yeah, this is the final design for this example. And to take it to the last step, I would download this. And so you have some options for different download opportunities. PNG is what's recommended by Canva. PNGs are a good file format to use if you're doing something that's a quick social media piece. JPEG is something that I would recommend using if you're using this application to create images for a website. And then working within PDFs if you're creating things that need to be simple email attachments or high print files. Here, I would just download a PNG, save it out, and then upload it to social media and post away. For more tips and tricks on how to use different design applications to create the best social media feeds you can, visit us at yakkettyyak.com.